excited to do a date in life with my one-year-old, which is so crazy. I can't believe Isaiah's one. If you saw our video, we got like a wild one theme, which is very appropriate. He's literally just nonstop. There's a lot like happening now that he's one. Well, he started doing this a little before one, but we are past the 5 a.m. wake-ups, which I'm so thankful for. We finally got those figured out. I just kind of like shortened his naps during the day and then make sure he has a really big dinner with a lot of healthy fats. And then I nurse him as well before bed. And I feel like that's helped a lot. So now he's doing 11 plus hours and doesn't get up till like 6:30. So today he got up a little after 6:30 and went to bed at 7:30 last night. Do you want to be on camera? You want to turn the TV on? You can play with the remote. I feel like I'm finally feeling like myself again. 1 year postpartum, it takes a long time, so have grace. I expected to feel this way way too early on, and then even at like 10 months I was still like so frustrated at myself. But now that it's been 1 year, I feel like I'm getting a groove. So anyways, enough talking. I'm gonna make him some breakfast and bring you guys along for a day in life with my one-year-old. Breakfast is semi-prepped already because I was making him this for part of his dinner yesterday and he didn't finish it, but it's just this full-fat Greek yogurt, this pureed date paste that I made. It's literally just dates soaked in warm water and then blended into a paste, so it's like a natural sweetener. I love it for like peanut butter and jellies and things because jelly has so much added sugar, and then this has peanut butter. I'm going to add some breast milk that I have, and then some oatmeal. Oh my gosh, you have another poopy. This is his third poopy today. I was just about to feed him, thought I smelled something, and you pooped again, third time. It's not even 8 a.m. and oh man, he's obsessed with berries. I really need to cut back on these berries because like these poops are happening like literally 8 times a day. It's like newborn stage, except newborn breastfed baby poop does not smell, and the stuff stinks.
Let's try this again, buddy. No more poopy. No more poopy.
You just want, whoops, water. He was not good with drinking water from his sippy cup for really up until like a couple weeks ago, or maybe even like last week, and now he loves it. He thinks it's the funniest thing and he's so proud of himself.
Show me. Can you show me how you drink your water? Yeah, so proud, so good.
It's 9:30 right now and he is, I believe, asleep. I don't have the monitor on me, but I can hear him upstairs and he's quiet, so I am just getting some computer work done, working on like making a reel, and I'm kind of like dabbling with the idea of potentially like dropping the nanny and watching him full time. So I'm trying to see how much work I can actually get done on the days that I watch him, because usually the days I watch him were Monday and Tuesday, and I would just be like fully present with him and not worry about work, because then I would have Wednesday, Thursday, Friday to focus on work. But now I'm kind of like, I wonder how much I could get done, because he's gotten so good with his independent play that I feel like I can get like a little bit of computer work done and just let him play in here, and then when he naps I can get work done. Now that we've joined Lifetime, I take him there for like an hour a day while I work out, so I don't like have to use his naps to work out or anything. And honestly, I just like spending time with him and I miss him a lot, and I don't know. So I'm just going to get as much work done as possible before getting ready for the day, because I am like still in my PJs and haven't washed my face or anything before he wakes up at 10:30. It's now a little after 10:30. He's still sleeping. I always end up having to wake him up because he just naps so hard. Like, plays hard, naps hard. So I can't let him sleep past 10:30, or then it messes up his next nap and then bedtime gets really late. He's usually like, once he gets distracted, once he wakes up and starts like playing, he's totally fine. So I just usually go on like my hatch and turn on turn off the sound machine and then start playing like birds or something and then talk to him. So right now I'm about to like talk to him to try to get him to wake up a little more slowly. And if not, then I'll like have to go in there trying to move around. So let's go get him.
We usually have something planned like immediately when he wakes up. We're either going to the park, this park that I love because they have the rubber mulch ground so he can actually like crawl around, or we're going to Lifetime Fitness and there's a daycare there and he'll just play for like an hour. But since we didn't have that, of course we ended up, if you know you know, we ended up at Target. So I definitely need to grab some groceries and I'm sure I'll find a few other things that we need. Target doing a small grocery haul, baking soda, baking powder, jasmine rice, microwavable for Michael, also for Michael, Chick-fil-A sauce. For Isaiah, I got these organic black beans that are low sodium, and then I'm just gonna rinse them to try to get as much sodium off as possible. Canned mushrooms, because it's just super easy. Some avocados for Isaiah. Trying out these different little packets for like snacks on the go. A couple of these just like soft cheeses that Isaiah likes on his toast. Coffee filters, favorite guacamole, decaf coffee because I cannot have like regular coffee in the afternoon or else it just keeps me up. Some unsweet almond milk, pink lady apples, the best kind ever. Butter lettuce, favorite kind of lettuce. Whole milk for Isaiah. I just like throw that in his oatmeal and random things sometimes. Sweet potatoes, because I love chopping and roasting them. Some bread for Isaiah, Greek yogurt for Isaiah, bananas for everyone. And then I did get this random little toy, so we'll see if he even likes it.
By like 12 o'clock, my hair usually goes up in a bun, but right now I'm making his lunch, and you cannot see the panic that is in me every time I hear a like noise, because the one thing I hate about this house is that the kitchen is just sectioned off from his playroom. So whenever I hear something, I have to like sprint out there. But right now I'm just making him, cutting up some grapes, gonna make him an egg toast with cheese. Also gonna make myself some eggs just to make it easier. Ate everything. Are you gonna finish it? There's two more toasts. High five. Yay! You did a good job. You did great. He finished off all of his lunch, but sometimes just to make sure like he's not still hungry, I'll grab like a pouch or something and see if he takes it. And if he does, then I'll offer the whole thing or maybe like go and get something else. But he's kind of like half wanting it, half wanting to play, so I don't know. No shame in the puree game because I feel like there's so much pressure to give them like table food and all of this, and he obviously just had like a whole meal of table food, and if he's still hungry and I have this and it's quick, then whatever, it's fine. This is just mango, carrot, yogurt, and oats. I like this beech nut brand because there's no like preservatives in it. It's really, really good. And then I also like the Plum Organics and the Sprout Organics. I think those are the names. Do you want any more or you just want to play? Are you all done? Yeah, you're all done. High five. Yay! About 2:15 and he's working his way down. I'm gonna start editing this vlog that I'm shooting right now, and I'll do this until about 3 o'clock. What you saying? I'm about to go work out. He got up at 3:30. We went for a short walk, played a little bit, and then are you gonna go play at the gym?
Just for a little. You can only go for an hour, so that's what we'll do. And then we'll come home and have dinner. Yeah. Oh, thank you.
What are you doing? You're testing your limits. You're always testing your limits. Uh-huh. Oh, I just love you so much.
Heading home with a very hungry baby. I believe that's why he's fussy, because he's not usually just like fussy for no reason. But I'm just going to be quick with the dinner situation, just make him like pasta because I know he likes it, with a little bit of olive oil, red sauce, probably some peas, sweet potato actually I'll throw in there probably, and maybe goat cheese or cottage cheese if we have it. That's like one of my go-tos, but I feel like I gotta be really, really fast because he is hungry.
I prepped this chickpea pasta during his nap, or at least I made the noodles, and then all I had to do was microwave these peas to throw in here. We already had roasted sweet potato, and then I just tossed some red sauce and olive oil. That is what he is eating right now. Loving it. Loving it. Got some good veggies, huh? And yeah, it's a chickpea, like plant-based pasta, so it's got some good fiber and protein as well. And this is how he will eat peas, and he's hit or miss with sweet potatoes. Also gonna offer him a little bit of avocado, but honestly, he doesn't seem to like it most times, so we'll see what he does. Do you like it? No, he's spitting it out. We tried, it's okay.
A lot of the times I'll eat dinner with him, but it's just me tonight. Or like Michael and I will eat dinner with him, but Michael is not home tonight, it's just me. And I kind of want to eat like a peaceful, relaxing dinner. So I'm just gonna wait until I do his whole bedtime routine and put him down and clean up. So I'll be eating like a late dinner, but it will be like a lot more peaceful than trying to stress myself out and like run around and cook something right now. Cause it's about 6:30 and he's gonna go down in like an hour. Do you want more? You have a noodle right there. Do you see it? Yeah, can you see your peas?
And this is what mealtime looks like afterwards. There is literally food everywhere, everything in the sink. So I'll have to clean this up, but I'll probably do it just once he goes down. Also need to pick up the living room.
You're crazy. He's done with dinner, and now it is time for me to clean up, do the whole bedtime routine, do like, thankfully not bath night. We only do it a couple nights a week because his eczema, but we will do lotion, jammies, read to him, like quiet time in his room, and then I'll nurse him and put him to bed. So all that will happen in the next hour, but our kitchen, our home is a mess right now. I am sweaty, I'm hungry, but I'm gonna wait to eat until he goes down. So I'm gonna end the vlog here. Also, my battery is dying, so it's good timing. So thank you guys so much for watching this day in the life with my one-year-old. I hope you enjoyed it. Learned something. If you have questions, comments, leave them below. And until next time, I will see you next time.